Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemy.
This is Navi and part of the instructor team at MakerDemy.
We have covered BLE and BLE mesh in detail in our previous Learn Technology in 5 Minute videos. In this episode, we will cover Bluetooth 5, its features and its applications. Bluetooth has been around for more than 2 decades. BLE was targeted for low power, low bandwidth, given its prime use being that it is used for wireless transfer of small amounts of data at the lowest power consumption. The Internet of Things came to prominence as device OEMs looked to leverage increased short-range wireless connectivity for a number of battery-powered devices, all built around the smartphone environment. So what is new in Bluetooth 5.0? Bluetooth 5.0 addresses the new demands from evolving IoT applications in terms of increased range and speed through multiple enhancements to the BLE radio, as well as an increase of maximum transmit power from +10 to +20 dBm. The three main features that were introduced are 1. 2x the speed, 2. 4x the range, 3. 8x the advertising capacity. Let's go over each of these and take a look at the potential IoT applications that could utilize them. First, let's look at the speed improvement. In older versions of Bluetooth, the data rate for BLE was set at a fixed 1 megabits per second. In Bluetooth 5.0, a new mode with a data rate of 2 megabits per second is introduced. This new data rate offers a couple of additional benefits as well. 1. Reduced power consumption, since the same amount of data is transmitted in less time. 2. Improvement of wireless coexistence because of the reduced radio on time. Compared to other low-power wireless protocols like Zigbee, Z-Wave and Thread, Bluetooth 5.0 offers the highest data rate even at the original 1 megabits per second data rate. With the addition of the new high-speed mode, more potential IoT applications become more feasible. Now let us look at the range improvement. Bluetooth 5.0 also introduced a long-range mode that utilizes an error correction technique called forward error correction. FEC allows the receiver to recover the data from errors that occur due to noise and interference. So instead of requiring retransmission of data when an error occurs, the receiver can recover the originally transmitted data by utilizing the redundancy in the data. This mode is referred to as the coded physical radio mode. The obvious benefit of using this new mode is the increased range, with the trade-off being higher power consumption and reduced speed. Ranges as far as 750 meters in line of sight have been recorded while testing with the long-range model. Finally, let's look at the advertising capacity improvement. Advertising essentially involves broadcasting packets that allow another scanning device to discover them. The scanning device may then decide to initiate a connection if the advertisement packets indicate that the advertising device allows it. In earlier versions of Bluetooth, the advertising data payload size was capped at 31 bytes. In Bluetooth 5.0, a new advertising mode is introduced, called extended advertising. Extended advertising allows sending up to 255 bytes of payload data per packet instead of the original 31 bytes limit. With increased advertising data capacity in Bluetooth 5.0, beacons can now transmit much more data, unlocking new IoT applications and use cases. As we can see, Bluetooth 5.0 introduced a few features that can be applied to a wide range of potential IoT applications. However, there are a few important key points to keep in mind. 1. The new long-range and high-speed modes are optional features as per the official Bluetooth specification, so a chipset or device that claims Bluetooth 5 support may not support either of these new modes. 2. To be able to utilize these new features, the two BLE devices communicating with each other need to support Bluetooth 5.0 and support the feature of in-rest. 3. Smartphones are still slow to support Bluetooth 5.0 and its new features. Even when the new hardware supports it, the APIs need to allow the mobile developer to utilize these features. With that said, however, the potential new IoT applications that Bluetooth 5.0 features introduce simply make its wide adoption inevitable on both the mobile and embedded side. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.